enabled.
Hello, welcome to a brand new episode of Inspirational Brands Make in India. I'm Monica Nanda. On this episode, we're going to continue our quest to find some of the most inspiring modern day success stories in India of companies that are living up to the Make in India vision of Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
मैं जिससे भी मिलता था पिछले दो तीन साल में हर कोई यही कहता था भाई अब तो बिजनेस यहीं से शिफ्ट करना है इंडस्ट्री यहां से शिफ्ट करनी है ये जब मैं सुनता था मुझे पीड़ा होती थी आज जब मैं मेक इन इंडिया की बात कर लेकर के आया हूं तो हम नहीं चाहते कि मेरे देश का कोई उद्योग कोई व्यवसायी जिसे मजबूरन यहां से छोड़कर के बाहर जाना वो स्थिति हमें बदल दी और मैं पिछले कुछ महीनों के अनुभव से कहता हूं कि हम ये बदल चुके
TTK Prestige has emerged as India's largest kitchen appliances company, catering to the needs of homemakers in the country for over 5 decades now. TTK Prestige is a part of TTK Group, which was founded in 1928 as an indenting agency by T.T. Krishnamachari, who was also pioneered organized distribution in India. The Prestige brand has been a consistent super brand in the category, apart from several other awards received in the areas of retail, product design and company performance. It is the first kitchenware company in India to receive ISO 9001 certification and the PET CE certification by TÜV Germany.
We have with us Mr. Chandru Kalru, who joined TTK Prestige as a product manager in 1993 and is today the managing director of the company which has the widest range of kitchenware in India. Hello, Mr. Chandru. How
Hi,
are you?
How are you?
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So, tell us a little bit about the time when you actually joined Prestige. You joined when the company was already flourishing.
Yes.
So what were the goals that you set for yourself and where was the company then as compared to the company where it stands today?
See, when I joined the company, it was largely a single product company. We were just in pressure cookers at that point in time. But the goals were clear that we wanted to go beyond the aluminium pressure cookers that we used to make in those days. Right. So we were just about to launch stainless steel pressure cookers and also non-stick cookware at that time. So 1993 when I joined, we were just about to launch these products. Our goal was clear that we wanted to take our leadership further in pressure cookers. Mm-hmm. Remember in those days we were only in outer-lid pressure cookers, right, which was just operating in one segment. But nevertheless, we were still ahead of every other player in the country. We just wanted to take that further and establish ourselves in non-stick cookware, which was a new line for us, which we did very well actually at that point in time. We've been launching products feverishly every year for the last so many years. Every year we bring out 75 to 100 new products. So the company is always growth hungry. We're always looking at doing new things, new different things, new finding new innovative solutions for customers. So it's come a really long way, 72 crores then to what, to more than 15-20 times that now.
And from one product to how many?
Multiple now, from one product category to over 25 product categories today. So it's been a long way.
So what do you think about PM's Make in India vision and how has this initiative affected your sector?
Well, the Prime Minister has been very, very inspiring when he says Make in India. It certainly inspired us. And we've made several investments to make sure that we get the latest and best manufacturing technology in place. To us, what the Prime Minister is saying is move out of your comfort zone and do something that will make you globally competitive. And that's something that we're really inspired by. And what we're trying to do is exactly that. And we have today the best manufacturing technologies to make in India, for India and for the world.
Now let's hear what the chairman of Prestige Group thinks about the Make in India initiative.
I think it's not only a fantastic vision, it was late in coming. The previous government should have done it. We've got hundreds of millions of unemployed youth. and the only way to employ them is to make in India. Agriculture will not absorb them. We have to set up manufacturing. And we at Prestige have anticipated this, and we have established huge capacities to make both for India and for export, and it's now coming handy because we're getting a lot of export orders.
So Prestige has always laid strong emphasis on promotion and sales initiatives and branding aspects. So has this given Prestige an edge over the competition? What is your brand philosophy?
The brand philosophy is clear. It has to give a lot of value to the customer. Mm-hmm. It's always about delivering a lot more value than what others deliver to the consumer. With that brand philosophy, obviously we're very aggressive in the market. We are always coming up with newer and newer methods of attracting the customer. And we've always been at the forefront of doing something very innovative and very different in terms of a marketing promotion or a sales promotion or any of those things. But all of it is to one goal. That is, we must add value and give and deliver value at all points in time. That's what keeps us ahead of competition.
Tell us about your wide product range and your future plans.
Well, as I said before, we've been launching 75 to 100 products every year, and most of our products are the result of immense consumer insight mining. We kind of understand pain points of the consumers and then see how we can offer solutions and not just products. Mm-hmm. We do not go for gimmicks. That's something we clearly stay away from. We are here to add value, and we are here to offer solutions to pain points. The consumer never tells you what is the product they want, but they can definitely tell you what pain points are there. Our themes on product development are very clear. They must be towards adding to health, time saving. They must be convenient to use, and of course, in line with the modern times, be great in terms of aesthetic. So all of these themes put together with the latest technologies to address pain points. That's been the philosophy.
Great. What are your key markets? And tell us about the new markets that you're planning to enter.
See, about 15 years ago, we were a very South-heavy company. And one thing we told ourselves is that we want to be truly national. Mm-hmm. And so in the last 15 years, we've developed products. Because India is not one country. I mean, the cultures are different, the cuisines are different. So we need different kind of products to address different needs of different customers. So we brought out these products and made ourselves truly national. We're no longer that South heavy. We are available across the country. We're the most widely distributed brand. And going forward, we want to bring in the latest products to address the new urban consumer. Now, also in the next few years, in line with what the Prime Minister has done for rural India, because there's such a lot of rural focus that the government is putting in, we are bringing out specific products that are more friendly to the rural consumers, mm-hmm. because clearly rural lifestyles are about to change dramatically, given that the government is committed to increase rural incomes. The Ujjwala scheme means LPG stoves are going into rural homes. And the moment LPG comes in, the kitchen suddenly transforms itself and everything changes in the way they do things. So for us, that's a huge opportunity. So there's a lot of products that we're bringing to rural India as well.
So how has the recent demonetization affected your sector in particular?
It was temporary. I mean, of course, those 2 months were difficult because we had a lot of our channels partners were very busy with handling what they had to handle at that point in time. So they were very busy. There was no cash, of course. Mm-hmm. And but it was very temporary. And we bounced back. The sales have gone up. And what it's done to our channel partners is actually told them that they need to be more compliant. They need to be more transparent, right, and things like that, which all of which is very good for the country going forward. So it was a blip and nothing more than a blip. And we're more than back to normal before that as well.
So now that India has been digitized, what are the new policies or the new brand strategies that you have for the digital India in particular?
See, digital India offers us opportunities to sell in places and to customers who we couldn't reach so easily. I mean, you talk about a rural consumer today. The smartphone, the internet penetration is increasing every day when we talk about the rural consumer. So suddenly they are now exposed to what their urban counterparts were always exposed to. it allows us to talk a very different language to the rural consumer, because they are now looking at you digitally. Obviously, our marketing programs are now getting aligned to have a lot more digital presence than we used to have before. And all of this digitization also means that they are looking at buying products that are more known, brands that are more known, and not just what was available before. So even if I didn't have a physical channel in rural India, for example, I now know how to reach that consumer and deliver my product. So all of that is very good.
So today it has become imperative to keep pace with the changing technology. So what are the latest technologies that you guys are using, and how do you adapt to these changing technologies and the system, and how has technology actually helped you grow your business?
See, as a company, we have always been looking at what's available across the world, because we participate in all kinds of trade shows, and we've been looking at different manufacturing processes, different manufacturing technologies. Most of them make you more efficient. We are today investing very heavily in automation to make sure that our manufacturing is more efficient and competitive to service the world markets. And a lot of new technologies have come into our manufacturing, for example. We've added forging technologies, we've added new impact bottom technologies to our capabilities. We have one of the only anodized or fully automatic anodizing plant in the country. So all of these new technologies we have towards improving efficiencies, making us globally competitive, and delivering that additional value to the consumer. So that's why we think that adapting to the new technologies would mean that we are able to always be ahead of the curve when we are bringing out new products.
So talking about technology, innovation and R&D has been an imperative part of Prestige.
Yes.
So tell us how this has been strategic in the growth of the company.
Oh, because we are so heavily dependent on bringing out new products every time to increase market share. We have a fully certified, government certified R&D center. We make very significant investments in newer technologies and newer products. All of them coming from the base of the consumer insights I spoke about. So we take those insights and then see how we can make out a solution product. And we invest very heavily in things. Not everything that we actually make there comes to the market, because we obviously do our tests and then validate whether that is a solution or not. Yeah. And does it deliver enough value or not. But the R&D is the fulcrum of our strategy to maintain leadership.
You just mentioned about a lot of trade shows that you keep attending in around the world. So how different is an Indian household and an Indian kitchen in particular compared to anywhere else outside India?
Very different. First, our cuisine is very different. So a lot of stuff that we do, they don't do. There's a lot of frying, there's a lot of spice, there's a lot of masalas, so the processes are very different. We grind a lot of our spices. A lot of that is not really done. I mean, there the spice quotient is much lower. Also, the way the maintenance of a kitchen happens in say, a Europe or in the West is very different from the way it happens here. We tend to wash our kitchens every day. Cleaning is a very, very important part that our kitchens go through. So our products have got to take all of that into account. There are no dishwashers in most of our kitchens. Most of them use dishwashers. So the needs are therefore different in terms of what kind of cookware we put out. Mm-hmm. What kind of appliances we put out. Even things like blenders and electrics that we bring out have different needs, because we have different problems as well here. Mm-hmm. We don't have a clear voltage as well as it's regulated outside. So our products need to be a little more robust. So, and people expect products to last a lifetime in India. So you've got to engineer that in that sense.
It's time now for us to take a short break. We'll continue with the journey of TTK Prestige after the break. Stay tuned. Welcome back. You're watching our special series, Inspirational Brands Make in India, and we are in conversation with Mr. Chandru, the Managing Director of TTK Prestige Group. Talking about the manufacturing capabilities, give us an overview of your company's manufacturing capabilities and tell us about the number of people employed at the factory and the kind of output that you you generate.
Well, we have the largest manufacturing capacities in both pressure cookers and cookware. We make aluminium pressure cookers and stainless steel pressure cookers, both of the inner lid and outer lid variety. And we have close to 10 million pieces capacity today, which is by far the largest in the country for pressure cookers. We can, of course, expand that very easily. And then we have the largest capacities in cookware as well. We make cookware in aluminium, we make cookware in stainless steel, we make nonstick cookware, we make hard anodized cookware, and we have impact bottom, we have brazed bottom, we have all kinds of technologies. In aluminium, we have forging, we have the normal pressing, and all of those technologies available. Our nonstick coating plants are almost fully automated, and they're mostly European design plants that have a very high level of automation that we use. So all of this is today available already with us. Actually, we are on par with any manufacturing facility, if not better than anywhere else in the world. India's only TPM certified plant we have in Coimbatore. We pass every global standard that you talk of in quality. So there's a lot of investment that we put in quality and systems behind those plants as well.
Today, TTK Prestige has a varied product portfolio ranging from pressure cookers, non-stick cookware and gas stoves to electrical appliances and kitchen tools. Its products are available across 25 categories. TTK Prestige has been introducing more than 25 products every year over the last few years and sells a product every 3 seconds. The company has over 540 Prestige Smart Kitchen outlets across 291 towns and cities.
So how many manufacturing units or factories do you have and what is your annual turnover?
We have 5 manufacturing hubs. One at Hosur, which is off Bangalore, one down south at Coimbatore, one in Gujarat near Baroda, one in Maharashtra near Thane, and one in Uttarakhand, which is in Roorkee. And these are the 5 hubs that we have. Most of our factories, we have lots of green initiatives there in terms of the way we use solar power, for example, the way we treat our effluents, for example. We make sure that we are very compliant in terms of pollution control systems. We, of course, have rainwater harvesting and reuse of that water. We try and not use any banned chemicals for anything that we have. We are very, very sensitive to the green part of our factories, so to speak, because that's something we feel is very important. And that's our way of giving back to the society as well, because we don't want to sit and spoil the world that we live in. And every factory is compliant or is constantly looking at newer and newer energy saving, solar power using, renewable energy using initiatives. And we make huge investments in those projects today. Our turnover, of course, today is in excess of 1600 crores in domestic market. And we're looking at seriously addressing the export markets going forward, because we have spare capacities. We have invested in those capacities in the Make in India theme, if you might say, so that we can make for the world now.
Talking about the distribution network, what kind of distribution network you have around the world?
Well, we don't own the Prestige brand outside the country. So, but we do export the Prestige pressure cookers under license from the brand owners outside the country, and those markets would be Middle East, Southeast Asia, and wherever they would let us do that with their distributors. Aside of that, what we now do is we've acquired the British company now, wherein we have a couple of brands there which we want to take forward. We are of course looking at supplying the British company from India, Make in India, looking at taking those brands outside. Otherwise, we export to all continents of the world, but these are largely OEM in the sense that we make for them in their brand wherever possible. And we supply to all the developed countries and Africa and the US and Latin America as well.
Great. So what are the challenges of producing or manufacturing or let's say making in India?
Well, the challenges are very simple. I mean, the quality benchmarks have to constantly be upgraded. Our own eye for detail on quality has to go up. Making in India has other challenges in terms of the infrastructure, which is fast developing but still not on par with, let us say, China. And the laws itself, the GST coming in would definitely help because that would make us a little more competitive for exports. There's no cascading of taxes after that. So as the infrastructure is developing, those challenges are now getting mitigated a bit. The movement of goods, for example, because of the better roads would mean that we're not actually wasting time in keeping goods on the road, but actually, you know, using them more productively. But these challenges do exist today in making us less competitive in that sense. We have very great talent in this country. Our labor is very good. Those kind of problems are not there. But there are certain reforms that you do need there as well, which I'm sure the government is working on.
So what would you wish in terms of the government policies which will probably ease the entire system, particularly for your sector?
Well, the labor reforms are still due. It's not politically easy to have those reforms. And that kind of sometimes comes in the way. But those are small challenges. The GST coming in, I think, is going to make things much better for us going forward, both within India as well as outside for us to be competitive. Otherwise, I think we are fine. I mean, we are in the right direction. Everything is going in the right direction in that sense.
So thank you so much, Mr. Chandru, for joining us, and all the best for your future endeavors.
Thank you, Monica. Thank you so much.
Well, that's all the time we have on this episode of Inspirational Brands Make in India. Do join us for our next episode as we decode another inspiring business success story. Until then, thanks for watching.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.